We are on a trip to Amasya City in the Black Sea region of Turkey. In the first two episodes, we learned about the town's history, met local chefs, tasted traditional foods, and learned how to make three dishes that pleased Ottoman princes. In the third and final episode, we will go to another city district, Merzifon, to see the local shops, taste the new maize kebab that a local chef invents. Then we will walk around the streets where Ottoman Şehzades lived, climb to Mount Harşena to see rock tombs of the kings closer, and finish our trip visiting the historical buildings. So let's begin. Hi everyone, good morning. Today I'm going to Merzifon district of Amasya. We're gonna film a special kebab there, invented by a chef. And they also have a mosque. It's from the 17th century, so we are heading now. Merzifon. This is the mosque from 1666. It was built. It has many different features, but the fountain is very interesting. We're gonna take a closer look. The importance is that the pictures in the ceiling, you see the beautiful paintings. There are three sections, and one is Istanbul, as you can see, the Beyazıt Tower, the Galata Tower, the bridges, the Bosphorus, and probably the Topkapı Palace. And when you come to the right, the picture of Amasya, the castle, the river, Yeşilırmak, and the Beyazıt Mosque, probably the bridge. And the third scene is the Ottoman army. Gördünüz o şeyi?
Yaraş kalmış
şöyle. Şurayı İstanbul gibi. Evet. Burası Amasya gibi.
Evet, burası da şey. Candies for the eat.
Kilo elmalar pazarlarda satarlar. Kilo kilo elmalar.
These are made from chickpeas, leblebi.
Bahçelerden kar gelir, kilo kilolar gelir, bahçelerden kar gelir. Thank you.
meşe kömüründe.
Meşe kömüründe.
Evet. Uzun uzun pirzolası. Bu antrikot büftemiz. Kontrol edeceğimiz burada. Bonfilemiz. Tekrar yine antrikot. Şişeye böyle ayrı ayrı yapıyoruz biz. Dolap da dinleniyor kesildikten sonra. Etlerimizi biz de 3-4 günde marine ediyoruz. Ondan sonra kullanıma açıyoruz.
This is normally used for in the war, but now it serves as heating the meat. And the, Mr. Shadi Bey has a slogan. He says that don't make war, make peace and food. After grilling the meats in the kitchen, he begins his show. It was 500 degrees. Now he's pouring the oil to make 250 degrees, and then he's gonna place the meat. Since he poured the oil, it helps to not to stick to the tofus, the metal, and also it's not gonna burn. And since it was heated to 500 degrees, the inside is still very hot, and it's gonna keep it hot for about 40 minutes while we are still eating. I got the smoke to myself. And this is a butter and spice mixture. Three kinds of salt.
Evet, tabağımızı. Kestiğimizde herhangi bir pembelik, kırmızılık hissederseniz topuzunuza dokundurarak tekrar pişirebiliyorsunuz. Miskamber şerbeti, evet. Osmanlı şerbeti, diğeri de Darul Şifa şerbeti. Kuşbunlu, alıç, merzibon karısı dediğimiz bir üzümümüz var bizim.
Evet.
Fatih Sultan Mehmet'in dedesi Çelebi Sultan Han'ın döneminde burada üzüm bağları varmış. Orada bir geleneğimiz var. Hı-hı. Beyaz biber, karabiber, tarçın. Bunların hepsini hiçbirisi ezilmemiş şekilde kaynatıyoruz benim bir doktor. Ve deme bırakıyoruz.
It's been about 15 minutes. I'm gonna check the heat. You see it is still hot.
Hoş geldiniz köyümüze.
We came to Kara Mustafa Paşa Köyü, village. It is about 10 minutes with car from Merzifon. So let's take a look inside. When you first go inside, it's a very decent mosque, but when you turn around and look up, you see these very beautiful and detailed, colorful paintings. Unfortunately, it was very dark to film, so I'm sharing these photos with you, but it's very beautiful and detailed art. It really gives the feeling that the mosque is built for a woman, a lady, which is the Kara Mustafa Pasha's mother. Back to the city, we are visiting the historical buildings with Mr. Gültekin from Amasya Tourism Board.
O da otel odası, tapane deniyor.
Çilehane Camii.
Anadolu'nun ilk halveti tekkesi aynı zamanda burası. Tekke burası.
Hı hı. We are passing through Sofular neighborhood where Şehzades, the princes of Ottoman, lived. As the silent witness of history, it's a place where many blessed people who took part in the history of Amasya passed by. The hospital was famous for its unique approach to treating mental patients by using melodious sounds and the sound of water as therapy. Music was also used to treat patients with physical diseases, and Bimarhane was a hospital until the 18th century. After a long trip, we finished the day with two traditional dishes. In Amasya, keşkek is essential for wedding ceremonies and holiday mornings. Meat, chickpeas and cracked wheat is cooked in a stone oven in güveç earthenware pot for about 12 hours. In my Aydın city trip 2 years ago, we cooked the region's version with a local lady. You can watch the episode from the links. The second one is the Amasya çöreği, traditional holiday dish. It's a rich bread with poppy seed paste and walnuts filling. And if you want to taste, this is the number one place to buy. Good morning, everyone. This is the third day. We are trying to finish to see some of the historical mosques and places, and then we're gonna return. On my behind, you see another mosque. We came to Gök Medrese. It is from 13th century. Very different in architecture and art. And this is the tomb we just entered. So we came back to the Yalıboyu, the river, and now we're gonna see the tomb of the kings. I mean, we can see it every day, even from our hotel, but we're gonna go up and take a closer look. It's very hot. It took 1 hour. It was nice. Also, the view of the Amasya is nice. We are happy that we came, but we should have get more water with us. We knew that it would be better in the morning. We couldn't make it until the noon time, so it's very hot. This is the railway. We crossed from under the railway. It is another half an hour. We walk to the other side of the river to see. Name comes from the shape of the minaret, as you can see. Burma means twist. And we came from those mountains. I just bought from this one. As a final stop, in 40 degree around 2 o'clock, we are in the Büyükağa Medresesi. It's a medrese school. The medrese has a unique octagonal plan used for the first time in this building and consists of the student rooms around octagonal colonnaded courtyard. The largest domed room was used as the main lecture room and now for the training of local youth to become hafiz. Memorize the Quran here. It takes about 2 years, as the imam said here, who works here. And we cannot go inside because of the pandemic. It is a school at the same time. So my friends, this is the end of the trip from Amasya. It was a nice, beautiful, busy 3 days. I have learned many new things, recipes, about the history, the geography, the beauty of the city, Amasya. I would definitely recommend you to come here and enjoy and witness yourself. It's really beautiful, everything. Thanks for watching. I hope to see you in another delicious Turkish food recipes, vlogs, and maybe in another city. Bye.